Awake, good morning, class 8. We'll be starting with the new chapter in chemistry, that is carbon and its compound. Okay? Now, first thing comes that what is carbon, right? So let me tell you that carbon belongs to group 4 of the periodic table. Symbol is C, you know that very well. Why group 4? Because if you see the valency of carbon, the electronic configuration will be for carbon will be what? 2 and 4. It belongs to group 4 of the periodic table. Why? Because it has 4 electrons in the outermost orbit. So its valency is 4. And very important that carbon is a non-metal. Okay? Now, its mass number is 12. Clear? Now, if I give you a quick intro, carbon is very important in our life also. You know very well that you take in oxygen and you give out carbon dioxide, right? The word carbon is derived from a Latin word carbo, okay? That means coal. If you see the orbital structure of carbon, it has 4 electrons in its valence shell. Correct. Now, we'll talk about carbon's occurrence. Okay? So, carbon occurs on the earth crust in both free state as well as combined state. Okay. When we talk about free state, it occurs as coal, diamond, and graphite. When you talk about combined state, you know that carbon, when reacts with other gases, it forms a combined state. Like hydrocarbons, a mixture of hydrogen and carbon, right? Then when we talk about carbon dioxide, so oxygen and carbon together, right? Is what in a combined state. Now, if you see this flow chart carefully, I'll tell you that carbon is classified into two forms, like it is a crystalline form and it is another one is amorphous form. That means one is in the pure form, crystalline is in the form of crystals, and amorphous is a non-crystalline form. That means you can get it in the form of powdery substances or indefinite shape. If you see coal, they don't have definite shape, right? So amorphous is non-crystalline, whereas crystalline that has perfect crystal shape. Okay, now they both are allotropes of carbon. Okay, now in my further video we'll come to know what are allotropes. Okay, by that time you understand crystal is what having a definite shape. The crystalline carbon form categorized basically in your course, there are 3: diamond, graphite, and fullerene. Buckminster fullerene. Okay, it's not mentioned here, but I'm telling you it's diamond, graphite, and fullerene. And when we talk about amorphous form, it is coal, charcoal, and lamp black. And coal again is divided into 2 parts: coal, coke, and gas carbon. Charcoal can be of 2 types. Either you can obtain it from plants or by animals. So when we talk about plant charcoal, it can be again classified into 2 parts, that is wood charcoal and sugar charcoal. When we talk about animal charcoal, it is again classified into 2 parts, that is bone charcoal and blood charcoal. Okay. Then, where can we find carbon in our day-to-day life? First thing in the atmosphere, right? In the natural water, when you cook food, right? In sugar, one very basic experiment is given in your book that if you take sugar in test tube when you heat it, what happens? After some times, it turns black, right? It turns black. So what is that black substance? You call it, it's charred. right? So that black substance is nothing but carbon. So in sugar also you have carbon, correct? Then you have in medicines also, you must have seen very very good examples in pharmacies. Everywhere you see carbons, okay? Then in the industries also, so there are number of carbon compounds that you find near you, okay? Then we'll talk about why so many compounds, carbon compounds in nature. Why do you need to study this carbon separately? Before this, I would like to tell you that in chemistry is divided into three parts: physical chemistry, organic chemistry, and inorganic chemistry. Okay, first is physical chemistry, where you do deal with the physical properties of metals and non-metals, elements, compounds, etc. How they look like, what are their appearances, when you perform the experiment, what is the desired result that you're getting. And when we talk about inorganic, okay, and the another one is organic compounds. Now all the organic compounds, organic chemistry deals with the study of carbon. It is a branch of chemistry that is devoted to the study of carbon and its compounds. Okay, so there is a separate subject, organic chemistry, named organic chemistry to study carbon. Okay, and other elements undergo under inorganic chemistry. Okay, other than carbon, whatever study of any metal or non-metal you do undergoes this inorganic chemistry. Okay, now question comes, what is the requirement for carbon? Because carbon is just a single non-metal, right? Carbon is just a single thing. You are studying under a big name. Organic chemistry is a vast branch of studying carbon. So what is the quality of carbon that makes it different and makes it unique? So we'll study today. Okay, so why so many carbon compounds are there in nature? Why you need to study so many carbons? And there came a situation that you need to make a new subject for it, another subject to study for carbon only. Why? Because carbon is chemically unique, and very peculiar quality of carbon is that the only carbon atoms have the ability